Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel SS Analysis. First of all, I would like to tell you that if you are watching this video first time, subscribe my channel to see my more upcoming videos on analysis of different commodities and equity indices. And second important thing is to watch this video till its end to understand it solely to take your decision. Your well like will motivate me to be regular in working more hard for you. So let us start the day to analyze the movements of Nifty 50 and Nifty Bank. So today I'm going to analyze this move in a monthly chart of Nifty. Here you can see that how the Nifty has tested the highs of 15,445 during the last month. And here you can see that how we have seen a sharp sell-off from these levels and finally ended at the levels of 14,540 during the month of February. And during the month of January, you can see here in the monthly chart that Nifty has formed an exhaustive candle, and now during the month of March, you can see that a sharp exhaustion is very much visible in the movements of Nifty. And here you can see that once again during the month of March, Nifty tried to test the highs of 15,364 but could not defend this level, and a sharp sell-off was there. And finally, Nifty ended the week at 14,744, which has resulted in formation of one more exhaustive candle which could keep this trend downward. Friends, here I find that if the Nifty starts the upcoming week with a gap down opening, we could see this sell-off could continue up to the levels of 13,767 during the upcoming week. And there I find that if the Nifty is not able to defend this next supporting level, we could see this downward trend to continue during the upcoming weeks. So here I find that once again we could see some buying from the levels of 13,800 during this downward trend. So here I find that this level could provide some support to Nifty, but this trend could continue to be under pressure due to third wave of COVID-19. We could continue to feel this selling spree in most of the global indices because recovery looks far away from here. So friends, here I find that the Nifty could continue to follow the downward trend in global equity markets. So friends, now let's check this move in a weekly time frame. So here in a weekly time frame, here you can see that how level of 15,240 seems to be an immediate resistance for Nifty in a weekly time frame, where you can see that any upward move above the levels of 15,240 provides a good opportunity to go short in Nifty, where you can see that this exhaustive candle formed during the last week got confirmation with the formation of this red candle, which has confirmed the continuity of a downward move in Nifty during the upcoming week, where you can see that the Nifty has found a strong support at the 9 days moving average in a weekly time frame, where some buying was seen from the lows of 14,340. So here you can see that how the Nifty found a strong support from the levels of 14,340 during the last week and finally closed above the 9 days moving average. But overall trend seems to be very weak with the re-emergence of third wave of COVID-19, which could derail recovery activities during the upcoming weeks, where I find that the Nifty could start the upcoming week with a gap down opening. And I find that if the Nifty is not able to defend the immediate support of 9 days moving average, which is currently at the levels of 14,744, this steep fall could continue in Nifty, where the next support can be seen at the 26 days moving average, which is currently at the levels of 13,110. So friends, here I find that during the upcoming weeks, the Nifty could test this supporting level of 26 days moving average. So friends, here I find that if the Nifty is not able to defend this level up to the end of this month, this move could derail the upward trend in Nifty. So friends, here I find that this downward trend could continue if the Nifty is not able to sustain above the levels of 13,736 We could see a sharp sell-off above this level in Nifty. Friends, now let's check this move in a daily time frame. So here in a daily time frame, here you can see that how the Nifty tested the highs of 15,445 on February 16, 2021. And since then, we have seen a sharp selling in Nifty, which pushed the Nifty up to the levels of 14,683, what the Nifty tested on February 23rd, 2021. And once again, the Nifty felt some buying support from these levels and tested the highs of 15,200. And once again, you can see that the formation of an exhaustive candle in a daily time frame on February 25th was followed by a red candle, where I find that this has confirmed the continuity of a weak trend in Nifty, where we could find a sell-off in near future whenever the Nifty tried to test these levels once again. Because here you can see that how the Nifty has tested this level of 15,166 but could not sustain above this level, and a sharp sell-off can be seen from the last few trading sessions. We have seen the Nifty has tested the levels of 15,330 on March 12th. But since then, the Nifty has been following a downtrend, which continued till Friday, when the Nifty tested the levels of 14,389, where it tested the upper end of Ichimoku cloud, where the Nifty could find some support. And from here, you can see that on Friday, we found some support from the upper end of Ichimoku cloud when the Nifty tested the lows of 14,366. So friends, here I find that if the Nifty starts the upcoming week from the same levels where it has closed last week, the Nifty could remain under pressure due to the third wave of COVID-19, which could derail the reopening activities all over the world. So friends, here I find that the Nifty could even start the upcoming week with a gap down opening below the levels of 14,378, where I find that if the Nifty is not able to defend the lower end of Ichimoku cloud in a daily time frame, which is at the levels of 14,178, we could see the continuity of a downward move in Nifty, which could continue during the upcoming week, where the Nifty could test the levels of 12,896 during this fall, where some buying can be expected from the levels of 12,567. Friends, here I find that once again the levels of 12,579 could provide some support to Nifty during this selling spree, where a bouncing move can be seen during the upcoming week. So friends, now let's check the movements of Bank Nifty in different time frames. So friends, here you can see a monthly chart of Bank Nifty. Here you can see that how the Bank Nifty tested the highs of 37,773 during the month of February 2021. And from these levels, Bank Nifty faced sharp sell-off from these levels and finally closed the month of February at the levels of 34,680. And once again, Bank Nifty tried to test the highs of 36,390 during the month of March, but remained under heavy selling pressure and finally closed on the last Friday at the levels of 34,161 after testing the lows of 33,361. So friends, here you can see that how the Nifty is showing a great exhaustion in a monthly time frame. So friends, here I find that if the Nifty is not able to defend the immediate support of 33,337 during the upcoming week, we could see this exhaustion to continue during the upcoming week, where the next support can be seen at the levels of 32,643. Friends, here I find that if the Nifty is not able to defend the levels of 32,643 till the end of this month, this downward move in Bank Nifty could continue, where the next support will be at the levels of 31,784. Friends, now let us check this move in a daily time frame. So here in a daily time frame, you can see that how the Bank Nifty tested the highs of 37,773 on February 16, and since then the level of 37,284 has turned into a strong resistance for Bank Nifty, where the Bank Nifty once again started to test this resistance on February 25th, but could not sustain here. And finally, you can see that a gap down opening was there on February 26. Since then, the level of 35,748 has turned into a next immediate resistance for Bank Nifty, where you can see that any upward move above the levels of 35,785 has witnessed a sharp sell-off from the levels of 35,479. What the Bank Nifty has tested on March 3rd and March 12th, the Bank Nifty has tested this immediate resistance at 36,589. So, friends, here I find that this level seems to be an immediate resistance for Bank Nifty, which continued till Friday when the Bank Nifty finally tested the lows of 33,361 before closing the day at 34,161. So, friends, here I find that this weakness could continue during the upcoming week in Bank Nifty, where the immediate resistance for Bank Nifty will be at the levels of 34,834 and the immediate support will be at the levels of 33,590. So thank you, friends. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, don't forget to share this video with your more and more friends. Thank you.